Adding products to your store is a core part of selling online. This video will walk you through creating a product within the BigCommerce control panel. First, go to Products. This is where you will manage your product listings. There are a few items to point out on this page. Use the eye icon to toggle a product's visibility on your storefront. When it's disabled, the product has been removed from your storefront, but not deleted. Click the eye again to make it visible. To feature a product, toggle the star icon on or off. When it's enabled, the product will display in the Featured Products panel on your site. If you click on the Action menu, you'll find links to view, edit, or copy this product. There's also a great feature here to view orders that contain this product. To add a product, click Add. There are quite a few options once we're in the Add a Product page. Not every detail will be completely relevant to your product, so don't worry about filling everything out. Only the following attributes are required to create a product. You will need a product name, price, category, a weight for physical products, or a file for downloadable products. Let's start by entering a descriptive product name. Next, enter the price. If you're looking for more pricing options, click here. These pricing options can be very helpful for things like tracking your actual cost price, the retail price, or the sale price. Most merchants can leave the tax class set to default. To learn more about setting up your taxes, see our tax overview article in the support portal or contact Avalara. You'll need to assign your products to at least one category. If you need to create a new one, you can do that here. You can assign a product to multiple categories if it's appropriate for your store. Next, choose your product type. By default, your product type will be physical, meaning you're shipping an item to your customer. You can also choose downloadable product, which means a customer can download the product after they purchase it. This is often used for PDFs, music, videos, and other digital content. You will upload your file under the Product Files tab. Let's continue adding details to a physical product. Here you can enter a SKU or stock keeping unit if you'd like to track your product's stock levels. This is required for selling on some external sales channels. Enter in the product's weight and then dimensions. Many real-time shipping quote services require dimensions in order to calculate shipping quotes for checkout. To ensure accurate quotes, you should weigh and measure the product in the packaging you're going to use. Here's where you'll enter a description of your product. You can easily add text, images, videos, and links to other products, web pages, or PDFs. We highly recommend you create a unique description for each item you add to your store. This will help your product show up in search engine results. Check out our SEO guide for more tips on optimizing your products. Here you'll see some optional product shipping settings. Changing these settings on the product page will override any setting you've set in your shipping manager. If you want to provide free shipping on this particular product, just toggle the switch on. Be aware that this means the product ships free no matter where in the world your customer is. If you want to avoid that, find tips on how to provide free shipping on the support portal. Last, we see availability settings. You can choose whether your product offering is available for purchase online, only for pre-order, or unavailable. Selecting this last option does not remove the product from your storefront, but will remove the Add to Cart button from the product page. Let's move on to the next tab, Images and Videos. To add product images, you can either drag and drop them here, or browse and select them from your computer. Don't skip out on adding image descriptions or alt text. This helps your images rank in search engine results. Simply try to describe what is depicted in the image. If you have multiple images, select which one you'd like to use as a thumbnail here. This will be your product's default image. You can rearrange the order by dragging them around. You can also add videos to your product pages. Search YouTube for the video you'd like to include or enter the URL. Select the video in the search results to move it to the selected videos area and it will be added to your product page. Next is the Inventory tab. Here you can choose whether to track your inventory on your base product or by options. The low stock notification sends you an email when you are running low on your product. This leads us to the Options tab where you can apply option sets to your product. Product options are things like color, size, pattern, material, and so on. If you have already set up options, you can apply them here. If not, check out our product options video to learn more. Now we come to the Custom Fields tab, which lets you add custom information to each individual product. These fields can be helpful for various product information like book ISBNs, product release dates, or anything that applies to your product. The Configurable Fields is a simple way that allows customers to enter required information during their shopping experience. Most merchants prefer to offer these options by setting up product options since they offer more functionality and flexibility. Next is the Google Shopping tab. Check out our resources to begin listing your products in this high-converting marketing channel. The Other Details tab is full of helpful settings for your product. You can enter brand names, show related products to shoppers, add bin picking numbers to help optimize your packing and shipping process, include warranty information for your customer reference, and more. Filling out the search engine optimization area is highly recommended for every product. This will help you achieve a higher rank in search engine results. The next tab is for delivery event dates. If you're selling a time-sensitive product or service, this allows your customers to choose a delivery date. You can set that up here or through product options. And last, we have the bulk pricing tab. Here you're able to set discounts on your product when a customer buys a certain amount. This is great for enticing customers to buy more. After you enter in all your product details, save and close. Now view it on your store by clicking here. This was a walkthrough of how to add a product to your store. For more help, search the support portal for guides and articles on adding products.